bars, the girl replay.
Shawty's like a melody in my head that I can't keep out. Got me singing like na 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 na. Every day's like my eyeballs, the girl replay.
Hey Blossoms, my name is Leah. If you're not already subscribed, make sure you're subscribed. Turn those post notifications on so you know when I upload a new video and hit that like button. Today's video is gonna be a Q&A, and let me tell you guys, there's gonna be a lot of tea and there's gonna be a lot of juicy information that some of you guys were wanting to know. I told you guys to ask me some questions on my YouTube on the community tab, and also told you guys to ask me some questions over on my Discord. So I got to pick some lucky ones that a lot of people asked me, and I chose some of the ones that I saw first because I did get thousands of comments. I wanted to also apologize. Well, not really apologize, but I wanted to say that I did not upload for 2 days because I was in my meet and greet. I was there for 2 days straight and I was on there for 11 hours, guys. I was just sitting on my PC meeting a whole bunch of you guys and taking a whole bunch of screenshots. So if you didn't get a screenshot, I'm sorry. It's that there's a lot of people. There's only one of me and 50 of you guys in my server. So keep that in mind, please. So it's kind of hard to talk to you guys all at the same time, but I do try my hardest. And I wanted to give a big shout out to these people that you're gonna be seeing on the screen. I don't really give shout outs, but when something catches my attention, like a positive comment or a funny comment, I usually keep it on my camera roll. So if I ever did do a shout out or ever wanted to show positivity, so go ahead and leave a positive comment, give someone a compliment, because my channel is all about positivity. It's all about respect, so you could get respected back. And I strongly believe in that. There will be some people who disagree with me, but if they disagree with me, you know, I can't really do anything about it. Because at the end of the day, there's always going to be a hater. There's always going to be someone who's trying to be rude. People will try to knock you down for no reason. So even if you're standing alone, make sure you keep standing. We also did host a tome giveaway over on my Discord, so you are going to be seeing the winner in this video. And also, I'm going to be playing in my meet and greet in this video, and I'm going to be doing an obby that me and Cloudy build in the meet and greet. And like I said, I did spend 11 hours on there, so I wanted to do something fun, and we did like this obby that was really cool. There was no checkpoints or anything because it was not coded. I do plan to make something separate where we could play like games and stuff like that as a group instead of putting it in the meet and greet, because I just want the meet and greet to be kind of for like pictures, and then I'll have the other game just for having fun and getting to talk to you guys and hang out with you guys. I also wanted to say that there's some people who don't like it when I talk in my videos for some reason, and there's a lot, don't get me wrong, there's a lot of people who do like it, but I find some comments here and there that say, oh my gosh, she stops talking at this point. Well, like, if you don't like it when I'm talking, then you could click out this video, because I'm gonna be talking throughout this whole video, because like I said, there's gonna be a lot of tea and a lot of juicy information about me. So yeah, one more last thing before I start getting into the questions, I wanted to say, make sure you do check out my Cotton Candy limited edition merch, and it's gonna go away when I hit 60,000 subscribers and never coming back. So make sure you do join my Roblox group. It will be in the store. And without further ado, let's get started with the first question. I want to apologize in advance in case I do mess up on the names. So the first one we have here is Quinn, and she said, hi Leah, these are my questions. What's your secret on having a successful YouTube? What did make your YouTube channel grow? And when are you doing a face reveal? So I do not have a secret on how my YouTube is successful. It's just hard work that I have mentioned in the past in my videos, that I spend hours editing every single video to make sure that it is the best quality for you guys. And also, what made my channel grow? It was my Neon Starfish video, because I got that Neon Starfish very early when the Star Reward pets just came out. So I was one of the first people to have a Neon Starfish. So that's why in my videos, I do overpay for all the starfish, and I talked about the values and stuff. So that is something very important. So when an item just drops and stuff, you should be the first one to come up with the item, even though it is hard. That's how my channel started to get noticed, because I was one of the first people who have a Neon Starfish on my channel. And when am I doing a face reveal? So I plan to do that when I reach 100,000 subscribers. But here's the thing. So I did If I Die, I Show My Face Reveal video. And if you haven't watched that, basically I'm doing the Tower of Hell. And If I Die, I have to show my face reveal. And I got so many negative comments on that because people were getting mad for no reason. I said, if I die, I didn't say if I fall or anything like that. I said, if I die, I will show my face reveal. So I don't understand why people were so mad. I did not die once in that video. So you guys have no right to be mad at me. It was not clickbait. And people were saying that it was clickbait, that I didn't show my face, that they're unsubscribing because I didn't show my face. Like, first of all, that's not my fault. Second of all, you should have read the title clearly and you should have read the pinged comment. I did made it several times very clear that only if I die I would do a face reveal. So that's why I'm thinking about if not even doing a face reveal, because I had so many rude people that it made me feel like some people don't even deserve to see my face, because there's so many YouTubers that don't even show their face at all. Putting your face out there on the internet is a big thing. It's something that's never gonna go away, and most of you guys need to understand that it's not that easy. There's a lot of YouTubers that don't do it. There's a lot of YouTubers who do it, but you just gotta respect every YouTuber's opinion, every YouTuber's choice. It is something that I shouldn't even have done if I don't want to, you know. It's something that I would reward you guys back as a thank you guys for subscribing, here's my face reveal. That's what I wanted to do. But since I got so many negative comments, I'm thinking about not even doing a face reveal anymore. Of course, though, I did get some positive comments saying like, oh, like it's her choice, she doesn't have to do a face reveal and stuff like that. Those are the type of comments that I was looking for, and I did try to like every single comment that said that, because at the end of the day, it's my choice. You guys cannot force me to do a face reveal or not. So I hope you guys understand where I'm coming from. So if you were a YouTuber, how would you feel if people were saying stuff about your video because you didn't show your face? Or like, put yourself in my shoe and tell yourself how you would feel, because at the end of the day, it is a big choice. But yeah, that is my answer to that. Maybe I'll do a face reveal at 100,000 subscribers. I'm not sure yet. Maybe I'll wait till more. I'll see how I feel at that time. Moving on to the next questions from Samantha. She said, was it hard at first you had less subscribers, or now when you have tons of subscribers? So I feel like it's hard both ways, because first of all, when you do have a little bit of subscribers, it is harder to get your channel out there. It's harder to have people subscribe to you because they look at your channel and they're like, they have a little bit of subscribers, I'm not sure if I want to subscribe or not. And it's just the reality of people. So, you know, it's really hard to force someone to subscribe to you. So that's why you have to make good content so people could be like, oh, I actually want to subscribe to her. Even if she has a little bit of subscribers, her content is really good, so that's why I'm gonna subscribe to her. So that's something you should keep in mind, just in case you want to become a YouTuber or you are a YouTuber. Make sure your content is good, make sure your content is something that you would watch yourself. And I did say that it's kind of hard when you do have a tons of subscribers. Not saying that I'm big or anything, but I am saying that, you know, I do have an audience. So what I'm saying by that is it is hard because you are expected to, you know, upload every day for your subscribers. You're expected more out of people, you know, like there's gonna be so many like more haters, there's gonna be more supporters, there's gonna be a whole bunch of different like views that you have to see things on now. So in both ways, I would say it is hard when you have a little bit of subscribers and when you have a lot of subscribers. So it just depends on your audience, it depends on the type of person you are yourself. The next one is from Midnight, and they said, how old are you? What is your zodiac sign? And how did you get into playing Roblox? And that's all for me. I love your videos. Thank you so much. And I also wanted to say, I am not going to be doing my age reveal until I do my face reveal. So it's going to be like a combination of both. So I hope you guys do respect that. I am also a Gemini, so I'm a June baby. And I started getting into Roblox. I got into it because my sister was playing Roblox on her tablet. She was in this game called Zombie Rush, and I thought it was so funny. I was laughing at her at first because it kind of reminded me of like Minecraft, you know, like I just didn't know what it was about, and I just saw her like killing zombies and I thought it was so funny. And she just started like tapping on her screen so fast, she's like, look, I'm killing all these zombies. So I just thought it was funny and I was like, oh, let me try. And so I started doing it, and then, you know, I started laughing with her and stuff, and then, you know, she was like, maybe you should make your own account. And I was like, okay, I should. So then we started playing together, and then yeah, that was my journey on how I discovered Roblox. Next question is from Lindsay, and she said, what is your favorite neon legendary pet? What is your favorite mega neon pet? Will you ever do a face reveal? And I already answered that question. So my favorite neon legendary pet is a neon shadow dragon, because that was one of my dream pets and I did finally get it, and I made a video about it, so go ahead and check it out if you haven't already. I tell you guys what I traded for and stuff like that. And my favorite mega neon pet would be maybe the mega neon bat dragon, and also a mega neon kitsune. So I also did make that one, and I don't know if you say kitsune or kitsune, but every single time I say one of those names, someone comments in the comments and they say, oh, you said it wrong, you're supposed to say it the other way. And then I say it the other way, and then someone else says that I said it wrong, that I'm supposed to say it in another way. So at this point, I don't even know. I'm gonna use either or. Next question is by Anna Beth, and they said, "Hi Leah, my question is, do you have any advice for beginning a Roblox-based YouTube channel?" So I do have advice, and I did touch on this on my other Q&A video, and I do talk about it here and there, but basically what I recommend is that you be your own person. Make sure you're not copying anyone else, because you want people to see that you're original. You know, sometimes here and there, get inspiration, get some video ideas from other people, but overall, you should be your own person, because you want people to notice you for who you are. And make sure you are creative, make sure you edit your videos, make sure you have an interesting title, a good thumbnail, and you should be good to go. It doesn't matter how many subscribers you have, as long as you know you're putting good content out there and you would watch it yourself, then that's all that matters, as long as you're having fun. Next question is by Jam, and they said, "What quote would you make to inspire us?" So I haven't really made a quote before, but I have made an inspirational speech before. It was when I reached 10,000 subscribers and I made like a special video for that. And I know a lot of people didn't watch it, but for me, it was like something special. So it's one of my favorite videos. And yeah, so if you haven't already, you could go check that out if you want. I took some screenshots and stuff with a whole bunch of subscribers there. And I did do like a massive giveaway. So yeah, something that I would say is that if you have a goal, don't let anyone bring it down, because that is your goal. And that's something that you should work hard for. And there's going to be so many people sometimes that are not going to support you at all. And you guys just gotta, you know, ignore them. Don't be with the people who are putting you down. You have to find people who are gonna help you and motivate you. You know, don't stay with toxic people. Always find positive people that are helping you out. And yeah, so don't give up on your dreams. And that's what inspires me. And that should inspire you as well to keep going, no matter how many haters there are, how many bad people there are in your life. Just ignore them, because they're not gonna be in your life forever. So keep that in mind. There are still a few questions that I have to answer. There's quite a lot. So let me start speeding up the answers for my questions. So the next question is by Serena, and they said, "Hello Leah, here are my questions. What is your favorite video that you have made so far? And what is your first ever dream pet?" So my favorite video I made so far would probably be "This Is Why You Should Never Bully Anyone" roleplay, because that did take me a while to make. But besides the point, that video was made to spread awareness of bullying, to stop picking on people, because I know a lot of people who have been bullied, and I read my comment section, and there's a lot of people who can relate to being bullied, sadly. So that is not okay to do, guys. So if you haven't already, make sure you do watch that, because it does have a strong meaning, and I would love that video to be spread out so people could actually stop bullying and spread awareness. And like I said before, my first ever dream pet was a Neon Shadow Dragon, and I did work super hard for months, and then I finally did end up getting it. So the next question is by Green Flower, and she said, "My question is, what pet in Adopt Me that you will never trade?" So I'm pretty sure most of you guys have watched my trading videos. So sometimes I make videos on like some rare pets that I have, and I see what people offer for them, and I don't really accept those offers, even if they're really good, because those pets mean a lot to me, because some of my friends helped me raise up, some of my staff members help me raise up the pets, and they do take a very long time to grow up. So it does make me not want to trade them, and I just see what people offer for them. I do not have to accept, but I'm showing you guys what people offer for it, just in case you have one and you wanted to trade it. But eventually maybe I would trade it. It just depends on the offer. But next question is by Anna Beth, and I have picked her before, but she had a really good question. So she asked, "Do you have any advice on getting rich on Adopt Me?" Yes, I could make a separate video on that, so I could help you guys actually get richer on Adopt Me, because I do have a really good collection. But my top advice is to farm your pets. So that means if you have extra pets, make sure you trade them and get better pets. And, you know, try to get 4 of each pet and make them neon, because when a pet is neon, it has more value to it. So people will actually overpay for those type of items, especially when they're neon, because people want to make megas. So if you can make a mega, that's even better, because people will overpay for those more as well. And also, when an item is new to Adopt Me, make sure you get your hands on it, because people will overpay for those offers as well. And then after a whole bunch of people are starting to get it, the value decreases. So also keep that in mind. So that's whenever you have something new, you should go ahead and trade it right away, and your inventory will start growing like that. I have more advice, but I would have to put that in a separate video. So if you want one, make sure you leave a thumbs up. And next question is, what would you do if all of your best pets were glitched and disappeared from your inventory? By Not Fluffy. Simple question, simple answer. I would quit and never come back. I would literally cry, because I spent months and years growing my inventory. So yeah. And I would probably send an email to Adopt Me to try to get all of it back, you know, because I have so much proof that it is my stuff. But other than that, yeah, I would probably just quit. Next question is by Lilia, and they said, who is your favorite YouTuber? And if you could choose any feature to be added on Roblox, what would it be? So I don't really have a favorite Roblox YouTuber, so I don't really know how to answer that. But I do be seeing a lot of good YouTubers out there, so credits to them. But if I was to choose any feature, I would be choosing the feature where you could sell your extra stuff. I know some people that need Robux, and they don't want to wear the hats or the same clothes anymore. They want to sell it, even if it's, you know, less Robux because it is used already from yourself, but just get some Robux back so you could get something else. Next question is by Roblox Roses, and they asked, hi Leah, my question is, how did you start off your channel? How did you come up with the name? So I started off my channel with making a neon turtle, and that one didn't really blow up. It was my neon starfish video, like I have mentioned before. And I came up with the name because I do have a blossom tree in front of my house, and my nickname is Leah, so I decided to put both of them together, Leah Blossoms. And I really love blossoms. I love the meaning it has to it, and I did go in more detail on my first Q&A video, but basically it means to me that you're growing into something better. Like a blossom is growing into being something beautiful, so that's what I take it in. And I decided to come up with that because my old username didn't really have a meaning to it, but this one I could call you my little blossom, so that's why it fits perfectly with me. Next question is by IIA, and they said, do you ever think about quitting YouTube? Because I hope you don't. So I haven't thought about quitting. I don't want to ever quit, but I have thought about taking a break sometimes because it is very stressful. My whole life is YouTube now. Like, I never have a break to myself. I always put my little blossoms before me. I don't take a break, like I mentioned, and I always have to do something for YouTube. Like, I have to edit a video, or I have to upload a video, or I have to hang out with my blossoms on the meet and greet. I have to do so much stuff, so it is very stressful. That's why I have thought about taking a break sometimes, or I have thought about uploading less now, maybe like one day yes, one day no, or like one day yes, 2 days no, something like that. So I always try to upload when I have time, but I always put you guys first. So I hope you guys do appreciate that, because it takes me so long. It takes me so long. You guys don't understand. Talking about that, the next question is by Star, and they said, how long does it take you to make a video, including filming, editing, and making the thumbnail? So overall, in a daily basis, it takes me around 8 hours. 8 hours straight sitting on my PC, editing, doing all that stuff, and then finally uploading. That's why I usually upload late, because I spend the whole day editing the video, making sure it's perfect for you guys to watch, and then I post it. So yeah. Next question is by Kendall, and they said, what languages do you speak? So I am Latina, so I do speak Spanish and of course English. Those are the only two languages that I know. I did have a French class back then, but I didn't really finish the course because I had other things that were more important that I had to get out the way. And I also did want to make a video of me speaking Spanish and having subtitles on the bottom in English so you guys can understand what I'm saying, because I think that would be really fun. That's why sometimes I have like an accent in some of the things I say, because my first language is Spanish. Next question is by Illy, and they said, what is your dream pet? My dream pet is a mega neon bat dragon for right now, and I do have an offer. My offer is a mega neon unicorn, a neon frost dragon, a neon bat dragon, and a neon dragon. So if you want that offer, go ahead and leave a comment down below, because that is my dream pet and I would record it for YouTube. So yeah. Next question is by Star again, and they said, is it stressful doing YouTube? Yes, it is very stressful for me, but I know some YouTubers that don't get stressed at all because it just fits in their schedule perfectly. But for me, it's just so much stress because, you know, it is new and I've only been on YouTube for a certain amount of time, so I have gotten to a pretty good place based on my hard work. So yeah. Next question is by Chloe, and they said, are you a collector? If so, which one? Yes, I am a neon pet collector. I have almost every single neon pet except for like some of the neon legendary pets, like the golden griffin, the diamond griffin, and stuff like that. I don't have any of those, but I do have mostly all the other neon pets because I've been working really hard. I've been playing Adopt Me since before they even had pets in the game, so that's why I have so many neon pets, because I actually spent time to raise them up. Next question is by Elise, and I'm not sure if I said that right, but they said, will you ever make in real life merch? If yes, I would totally buy it. Thank you so much. And yes, I do plan to make in real life merch, and let me tell you, it's gonna be so fire. I'm gonna wear it all the freaking time, and I'm gonna be so excited. But yeah, stay tuned for that. I'm not sure when I should drop it, but I really want in real life merch. So yeah, stay tuned for that, guys. Next question is by Anika, and they said, what is one thing that you never thought could happen in your YouTube channel, and yet it did? So I never thought that I would get this far. My total goal was to have 1,000 subscribers by the end of this year, and now my goal has like a few zeros added to it. I want 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year, and I am working so hard to try to get to my goal. So please subscribe if you haven't already and you made it this far to the video. Come on now, it only takes like a few seconds to subscribe, so it would really help me out, because like 90% of you guys that watch my whole YouTube don't even subscribe. So that is a huge percentage, and it would really help me out if you did subscribe. So thank you so much for watching even this video, even giving it a thumbs up or commenting a positive thing on this video would really help me. Next question we have here is by It's, and they said, why did you switch from I2YBI Plays to Lia Blossom? So I have mentioned that on my first Q&A, but basically to make it short, I didn't have anything to call you guys from I2YBI Plays and Lia Blossoms. I could call you guys Little Blossom. So I wanted like a nickname to call you guys so we could have a better connection with each other, so I could actually call you guys like a little cute nickname to go by. So I also did change my themes to like blossoms, and I think it was overall the best thing I could have done for my channel, because it's just better when your channel is aesthetic. A lot of people tend to catch attention from that, so that's another tip for you YouTubers who want to grow your channel. The last question is from Mila, and they said, how tall are you, what is your dream job, and will you do an age reveal? So I already talked about that I'm not gonna do an age reveal until I do my face reveal at the same time, and I am 5'2". I know I am pretty short, and also my dream job is to do something in business. So my YouTube would be something that I have on the side, and then my dream job would be something to work on in business. So yeah, without further ado, I hope you guys did enjoy this video, because it was a lot of talking. I know this video is pretty long, but I wanted to get everything out there. If you have any more questions, you could leave a comment down below with your question, and I'll try to respond on the comments. Thank you so much for 50,000 Little Blossoms on my channel. I couldn't have done it without every single one of you guys. If you made it this far in this video, I appreciate you so much. Go ahead and leave a comment down below and put 1, 2, 3, and don't put anything else, so I know that you watched it until this far, and I will try to like your comment, because you are special to me, because you are a real Little Blossoms. I love you guys so much, but without further ado, I hope you enjoy this video, and I hope to see you in the next one.
Yes, of course.
Oh, my, 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 my,